Carlos from realtiesfishing.com. Today we're gonna go ahead and work on the low pressure fuel pumps. We're gonna go ahead and work on it. It's a 250 HPDI. Pretty simple removal and replacement of the gaskets. We're gonna go ahead and show you the kit that we're gonna use. I'll drop down the part number down below. And yeah, pretty simple task. It'll take about 30 minutes per fuel pump and we'll get to it. Let's go. This right here and this right here are your two low pressure fuel pumps, and they only take a 10 millimeter bolt on each side, and that will loosen it completely from the housing. And we're gonna go ahead and remove, as we did, the tie wraps that we had here. Make sure you put back tie wraps that are made for fuel lines. They're a little bit different from your standard tie wrap in the fact that they the way that they are shaped, it allows for a full 360 grab when it tightens, versus a standard tie wrap that'll leave a little gap right by the head of the tie wrap. So you want to get fuel related tie wraps for these. Okay, to reach this top low pressure fuel pump, the VST system is kind of in the way. Easy trick to do this is you're gonna go ahead and remove this and the top right bolt. And then we're gonna go ahead and loosen this one. We're not gonna take it out, we're just gonna loosen it. So just loosen it. See, we got that one removed and that one removed. And what that's gonna let us do is it's gonna let us see how it moves now. It's gonna let us move it just enough out of the way so we can access that 10 millimeter bolt. Remove this tie wrap. All right, guys, so they sell the kit for the low pressure fuel pump, all the gaskets, the little spring, the little metal clips. They sell all that so you can individually fix the part that's going bad. Anything that's gas related inside of a fuel pump, once you open it and things start to dry out, they start to expand. So best thing to do is replace all the gaskets, replace all the pieces inside the fuel pump. When we went to go purchase the kit, this is the model number of the one that we purchased. For just a couple dollars more, I think it came out just below $50. We bought the entire low pressure fuel pump with all the new gaskets inside, basically plug and play. It's gonna make the job a lot easier. All we really needed to do was remove two bolts, two tie wraps, and we're put it all back together and we're back in business. So we went ahead, went that route. That way we don't have to mess with replacing all the gaskets and whatnot. However, I am gonna go ahead and open one so you can see what the internals look like. And if you wanted to go ahead and replace some parts, what it would look like when you go ahead and do it. We're just gonna go ahead and swap these out. It was pretty cheap. So stay tuned and we'll keep on going. Okay, so something I like to do, especially on things like this or on filters, I like to put the date I replaced it. So June 2020. And what this does is when we ever go to do our maintenance, we could tell when we last replaced it and if we think we should replace it or not. It just helps with the maintenance. Alright, as always, a little bit of grease on the bolts. Alright. Time to connect this bottom one. We got the gasket on in the back. Go ahead and fit this fuel line. Don't pinch it too hard, just enough to get a grip. Okay, that seems good. Last but not least is this bottom hole. All right guys, so that pretty much wraps it up for the low pressure fuel pumps. Pretty simple task to do. Took us, with filming, took us maybe 45 minutes to do. Went ahead and replaced 4 zip ties. Remember, you want the fuel grade zip ties, the ones that are meant for fuel lines. They just happen to snug a little bit better than a regular zip tie. And that avoids having air get into the hose lines, and that will make you chase your tail for forever until you figure out that you have air leaking into your fuel line. So want to avoid that issue altogether. And basically the low pressure fuel pump, a couple things that are going to hint why you need to replace those is going to be a rough idle, no power. When you go ahead and try to accelerate, the boat doesn't get on plane. You've gone ahead and changed your filters and you still feel like you have bad fuel or fuel's not getting to the engine. So that's one of the reasons why, and basically it just disintegrates, especially if you have ethanol laced fuel. We always recommend Rec 90, but ethanol will go ahead and break down the diaphragms inside those low pressure pumps. So want to go ahead and replace those maybe every couple seasons. Yamaha, I believe, recommends 300 every 300 hours. If I'm incorrect, just go ahead and correct me down below. But basically, quick, easy task to do, around $50. I think it was like $3 for the gasket in the back, so not a bad job to do. And that's about it. So make sure you subscribe, you like, make a comment. If you have any videos that you would like us to do, go ahead and comment down below. This is an HPDI. If you have an HPDI, shoot us a message. We'll go ahead and do a video, gladly to do a video. So that wraps it up. Make sure you subscribe. Thank you.